What's up, guys? This is Inhaze, and welcome back to the third episode of the Custom Map Tutorial Series. In this video, we're going to pick up where we last left off and cover more in-depth world edit selection commands and region operations. Last time, we learned how to make a selection with our wand and use the position commands to generate it that way. Also, how to manipulate it around, shift it, change the size, expand the different sides of it. So now that we know how to do that, we can actually use the commands that will change the blocks within the selection. And the first and most basic command is the set command. And that just takes one parameter, and that's the block ID. And it will change all the blocks within your selection to that. There's some wood planks. But you know, that doesn't really come in too handy, because who needs solid blocks? I mean, that helps for like long things, but let's say, here, I'm just gonna undo that. Let's say we just wanted to, I'm gonna make the selection a little bit bigger too. Let's just say we wanted to like change this top layer or all this grass to, I don't know, like dirt or something. You can actually use the replace command. You type in what block you want to be replaced and with what you want it to be replaced with. So we're just going to type in 2, and you can use either the number for the ID or the actual name for it. So we're going to replace all the grass blocks with dirt. As you can see, all the grass has been replaced with dirt within our selection. So those are the two most basic commands you can use with a selection: setting blocks, replacing blocks. But it's with other parameters where it can get a lot more detailed, and you can have a lot more, what I like to say, smarter commands that will allow you to do a lot more different things. One of the first things it allows you to do, instead of just setting one constant block to set the whole area, you can actually set a pattern of up to like 5 or 6 different blocks, I believe, where each block will have like a certain probability of coming up, whatever percentage you set. So let's do that same command, except we're gonna replace the dirt with, let's have it either be 50% stone, and all you do is put 50% and then the block ID right next to it, and then a comma, and then what you want your next set to be. And it's going to be, and it always has to equal 100%. The next is going to be 50%. Let's do, I don't know, let's just do 17 for wood. So now you have a 50 and 50% ratio of the wood and the stone, or approximately that. So that's one really nice thing. And you can do like multiple things, like let's try. And that also works for like a whole bunch of other commands. Any world edit command that would take a normal single block ID, you can also put a pattern in of like any percentage. So like here, let's do set, I'll do 10%, 1, and 90%, 2. Now you can see there's a lot more grass blocks now than there is the stone. About a 10 to 1 ratio. So that's how you do that. That is a pattern, and you can do that, like I said, with about 5 or 6 different blocks with all sorts of different percentages, and it'll give you just a random distribution of whatever you put in there. Also, with that replace command, I want to show you, you can actually replace multiple blocks at once. Like, let's say, within our selection, if you just wanted to do, like, here we'll do 2 and 1, since that's what I just did to set it. We'll just do 2, 1, 0. And now it erased all that and left just the dirt that had changed over behind. So that's how here, actually, I get a really cool example of how that replace command can be used. So we're just going to expand this vertically, and we're going to replace stone, dirt, grass, gravel, sand. We're going to replace all those with air, and all that should be left is just the ores and other minerals. So if we look now, oh, look at all that ore, even some nice block of diamond there. Very nice. So that's one kind of useful aspect of this, or a good example of how that replace command works. See, it's like perfect too. All the way down to the bedrock. We'll just undo that real quick. Clear our selection. So that is how the set and pattern and replace commands work. Oh, also I want to say you can set the damage values too. Like for if you want to do red wool, you can do 35 colon red, or use a number also, and it will set the damage values. I'm gonna undo that. So the next one is a little bit different here. Let me get this selection a little bit better. Is the walls command. It's kind of like the set command, except it will only affect the walls or the outside areas of your current selection. So let's do walls, and it's just one parameter, or you can use a pattern like 50% one, 50%. Oops, 50% 1, 50% 5, and then you can have an assorted wall that goes around your selection. The same thing can also be done with the outline command, except that also adds a roof and a floor to the selection. So there you have that. If we no clip inside, there's the inside. So it's completely hollow little box. That's a good way to just create like a starter shape for like a little house instead of just having to do all those layers by hand. You can just do outline 5 and then you have like a starter shape for a house. It saves a lot of time just putting down all those layers. So that's the walls and outline command. The next command is going to be the overlay command. Let me just do this, replace two with dirt. Say you have a big area like this, you can use the overlay command to overlay any sort of block type over the top layer of your selection. So it'll only overlay it over whatever is the topmost layer. And that's just overlay. And for this, we're just going to do grass block. And it actually adds a whole new block on top of your area. I don't really use it too much because sometimes we'll do odd things like this. You'll try and put them on top of flowers. So I actually have another method I use for changing over everything to like a green to the grass block. So, but that's the overlay command. You can use that. Sometimes it's helpful if you have like a real large area. And like you don't have to worry about flowers or anything like that. But that is the overlay command. The next command is a pretty useful one. It is the stack command. It will allow you to stack whatever your selection is in any direction. It'll like butt it right next to each other as many times as you want. So you can like stack this like 100 up, and we'll just make a huge column all the way up with your selection. Same thing for any direction. Stack 3. Just put however many times you want it to be stacked. That's a very useful command you'll probably be using a lot. It can take any block type and pretty much any shape, and it'll just like butt it up from one end to another over and over. So that is the stack command. The next command is the move command, and that will actually allow you to shift your blocks around within your selection. So opposite two, when you do the move, let's just move this one, it'll actually shift all the blocks in there to the right one, or to whatever direction you're facing, just like the expand command, just like almost any other direction based commands. And you can also put a fill block in there, so it'll fill in just a certain block in the empty space left behind, but it's not really something you'll probably ever use that often. So that is, oh, also, there is a parameter to actually shift the selection, because when you use the move command, it moves your blocks, but it doesn't move your selection with it. Your selection will still stay in the same spot, so if you have to like keep moving something over, the selection, it doesn't really work right. You have to put in an extra, let me just move that back. If you go move dash S, to it'll actually shift your selection with the blocks when they move. So that is kind of helpful sometimes. So that's the move command. The next command, I don't really use too often. Some people might. It's the smooth command. Here, let me just, let me just generate something real quick. The smooth command will try and smooth out uneven terrain, like cliffy areas and stuff like that. I don't use it that much because I have a smooth brush that I use normally that works a lot better. So, but I mean, this, like, again, for some of the other, like the overlay command, it's good for a huge area if you would have to use it, but not so much if you just need a small area done. But that's just smooth, and you can put in how many cycles it'll go through. The more cycles, the more smoothing that'll be done. So if I just put in smooth 2, you can see it just kind of smooths in our large, ugly block we had there with a nice smooth, or somewhat smooth, little hill. But that is the smooth command. And there is also a G mask that is kind of important. Actually, it's really important for your selection. It allows you to set different blocks. It's basically like a filter for your selection when you're using like set commands or replace commands. So it will only change blocks that you have set in this filter. Like if I have, if you do gmask, we'll just do 5 since there's no wood planks in here. I know I'm not going to hit any. If I just do set zero, normally it would change this whole area to, man, I don't know why this is so laggy all of a sudden, sorry guys. It would normally change this whole area to air, but instead, since it has the G mask on, and there's no wood planks in there, it has nothing to change since nothing is like getting by the filter. But if I change that G mask to 2 and do set 0, it'll change all my grass blocks to air. So that can be used in a lot of different ways. It can also be used in brushes. It's not so much useful in the selection as much, but there are a few things you can do. Like, for example, another thing you can do is the over and under filters. So if you do gmask over 2, it will only, here, let me do this, expand 4 up, it will only allow it to change blocks that are over a grass block. So it's kind of useful in a few different situations. Like if you wanted to put grass down or like saplings or something, you can make it so it would only put saplings or whatever down over a grass block. And it also works the same way for under blocks too. So now that I have that G-Mask set, let me show you. Set 5. So you can see it's only putting it over the grass blocks. It's not putting it over this dirt, and it's not putting it up in these air blocks like it normally would. Like if you, let me undo that. Take that G mask off and do the same thing, set 5, and you have a completely solid block of wood planks. So that is the G mask. You will probably use it, like I said, more in brushes, because brushes also have an individual mask that you can set. So they have two total masks that you can set for those, which makes them even more useful. We'll go over that here in the next two episodes, though. But that pretty much covers all the selection commands, or at least the most important ones. So until next time, guys, I will see you later.